Confusion reigns in the studio. Here we are in London. Hamish and Andy sitting in your studio, Christian O'Connell. It's breakfast time here in London. It's
and I should be saying good afternoon.
We should be saying good afternoon.
In Australia.
We are live across the UK right now, and this is the Christian O'Connell Breakfast Show. And then we need to say welcome to everyone listening right across Australia. And we are driving Australia home.
Yes, we are.
So they've Australia has had Friday.
Australia is ready for the weekend.
Wow. Which
is
so they're in the future. But let's make this more complicated. Yeah. We are a time traveling radio show now.
We talked to some people in Australia. We haven't quite got flying cars, but they're jumping really high by this afternoon.
Have you got jetpacks by this afternoon?
Yeah, that happens at about 12:15 this afternoon.
Really? Lunchtime?
Everyone has lunch, gets jetpacks, and then really one of the hot topics over afternoon tea was, how about those jetpacks?
What I wanted to do was, basically, I've been waiting for you guys to come on the show quite a while, because for a lot of Aussies, basically, you touched on it before, it can be quite cold and lonely in London. Yeah. I've written a witty ditty.
Have you written your own parody song?
I think he's written a poem for you.
Hamish Blake and Andy Lee, two of the greatest guys you'll see. Comedy skits to make your day, a taste of Oz while I'm far away. English people can be cold to me. I'd like to make some friends, but you see, English friends are hard to find, but your Aussie voices help me unwind. Hold on, Andy Lee and Hamish Blake, give me a spot on your show, for goodness sake.
You're on next week, and I think you're so special. I reckon a one-off appearance rather than a regular
thing. They're being cruel here,
you
David.
You don't need to take the mickey. I've phoned up in good faith to do a poem.
Yeah.
And this is just a sort of attitude.
Yeah.
Why I left Oz in the first place.
We want you on the show next week. We want it, but we've got to have a different poem for everyone.
I mean, they're doing a show now, and they don't want you on this one.
We're not on the show.
Well, he's already done a poem. Right, I mean, we've got to get to the news.
They're trying to bump you off. They give me the sign to bump you off.
Who is David?
Who is David?
Oh, yeah, it's not me.
This is not... Damon, you're not real.
Stay on the line, Damon.
I have phoned up and I've written a poem and you bloody laughing shove it. You can shove it. You can stick it up. You bloody bum nugget.
Oh, I thought you said no blue. You said no blue. You said no blue. Talkie from Sydney.
Whatever is said, just hear the accent and then pick it. There's a rodent in the hood.
I picked the rat.
I picked the rat. I picked the rat if you could.
Yes, everybody. It's time for Pick the Rat. Yeah. It's the public versus us three. This is where we've got a band together. What we want is we're going to pick two Australian listeners. They're going to call in 131060 with regular Australian accents. And then we need one London listener with a regular British accent also in the mix.
Yeah.
They'll all have to say one phrase.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is. Well, I mean, you introduced us to that phrase with fake caller Damon, which was now, well, there was the black mark on the show, which happened approximately 20 minutes ago.
They will each get a chance to say that phrase once.
And so we've got to guess.
The one British person who's doing an Aussie accent is the rat.
And we've got to
we have to pick.
This is terrible.
We have to pick the rat. Yeah.
What do we win?
I'm really glad you asked. Ando.
If the rat is successful, meaning we do not pick the British person putting on an accent.
That's a victory for rats.
For rats, and they will all win cheese.
All three callers win cheese.
Right.
If we are successful...
So we are sending via airmail today cheese to Australia.
That's all right. It's already... It's been around for... We'll send it in a rind or whatever. It's not going to go off.
If the rat wins, we do. But if our three minds, beautiful minds combined, can pick out which Londoner is trying to put on an Australian accent, it's a victory for humans and we'll send all three competitors mousetraps.
Because a victory for humans is a loss for rats. So we put three more mousetraps into circulation.
Oh my God, phones have lit up.
Phones have gone crazy.
Richard's up first.
Go for it, Richard. You're only allowed to say the phrase. We will not say anything else to you.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is.
Thank you, Richard. Okay. That could have been a rat.
Let's have a listen to Steph.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is.
She's rat-free. That's Australian.
You're
that's
sure?
as an Australian as a as a
no no
as
no,
an
no.
Australian. That's a koala wearing a cork hat. We're not being hustled by Steph
with corrugated iron blundstones. All right. Let's have a listen to James.
Mate, I don't know whose bum nugget that is.
that's bloody Australian Andy.
Yeah, I reckon that's real.
I think that was Craig McLaughlin. Or check 1-2.
All right. Oh,
which is coming up soon, Shock the McLaughlin. Another contest we can play here on the show. Look, I am tentatively drawing a piece of cheese next to Richard, our first caller.
How are you feeling over there, Christian?
I think it's Steph.
You really think Steph?
Yeah, I think it's Steph.
Lady Rat. It'll be our first Lady Rat.
Yeah, a sexy rat.
Well, no one mentioned she was sexy.
Oh, okay.
I mean, because you know 50% of rats are women, and I'm worried if you find them sexy.
I'm leaning towards Steph as well.
Are you really? Yeah, well, if it's 2-1, guys, bearing in mind, a lot rides on this. If we get it right, three mouse traps go out into the population and more rats will die.
Yeah.
If we get it wrong, we have to reward them all with cheese. Now, that's why I'm urging you not to take this lightly.
Do you know what? I'm going back to Richard.
Oh,
wow! Yes.
This is why the game is amazing!
Well, no, it's not amazing. This is the stinkiest thing I've ever done on the radio. It's terrible.
Cheese. Do you want to come across to Steph now, Ham?
I'm holding firm on Richard.
No, I think it's Richard. Yeah.
Okay, Richard, are you the rat?
I'm from Liverpool, I'm the rat.
Richard, you have won yourself a mousetrap. Steph James, you're getting the same.
Everyone, it's a victory for humans and a loss for rats. Three mousetraps will roll off the production line at 9:01 UK time as soon as the mousetrap factory opens. I almost feel like we should stick around just exclusively here on Absolute.
We can. I've still got another hour to do.
No, we're just joking. We're going to go home. Okay, thanks, mate.
We should thank everybody for listening across the UK today, as well as all of Australia.
Australia, thank you very much for listening to this unique radio show. We've loved doing it.
This has been so much fun.
I hope it's worked for everyone.
To the UK, thank you for having us. It's so weird. It must be so weird for you that this is like 75% of the way through your show and it's the goodbye. But thank you to everyone listening here in the UK and Absolute, and of course everyone listening at home and all the people that made it possible. And you know, going back to bed.
Right.
Till next
slackers.
Friday.
Bye. Thank you very much, everybody.
We did it.
Fuck, that was great.
It worked.
Just you'll notice that I held my groin back.
Yes, that's
me. Oh, mate, that was brilliant.
It worked.
Well done. You got it all to air.
Oh, that was great.